Our next lesson is mixing problems, one of the application ng first order differential equations. So here's the fundamental principle that we will be using. The rate of change of the amount of salt in a tank is equal to the rate of change of the amount of incoming salt minus the amount of outgoing salt. So mathematically, yun raw rate ng amount ng salt or change ng amount ng salt in a given tank is equal to yung rate ng pagpasok ng amount of salt minus yung rate ng paglabas ng salt dun sa mismong mixture. So, B is the rate of inflow ng mixture. CI is the rate or the concentration ng inflow mo. So, yung concentration ng mixture na ipinapasok natin sa tank is minus yung rate of outflow multiplied by yung concentration na inilalabas natin dun sa tank natin. So, example, ito yung tank natin. Of course, meron siyang volume expressed in liters or in terms of gallons. And the amount of salt is expressed in kilograms or expressed in pounds. So, ito yung rate of amount of salt na ipinapasok natin. So, which is defined by B in, which is expressed in liters per minute. So, yung pagdagasa ng tubig na merong concentration na salt. So, C in is kilogram per liter. So, once we multiply this B in times C in, so yung liter magka-cancel out, magiging kilogram per minute. So, amount is expressed in kilogram per minute, which is expressed in, yung time is expressed in minute. So, similarly, ang rate of outflow ng, or the amount of salt na nilalabas natin is given by B out, which is liter per minute or gallons per minute, multiplied by CO, which is expressed in kilogram per liter or pound per gallon. So again, pag minultiply, same lang naman ang makukuha natin na kilogram per minute or kilogram per second. So depende kung ano yung given time natin. So i-apply natin itong working equation natin na dA dt is equal to rate of inflow multiplied by the concentration minus rate of outflow multiplied by the concentration. So, solve natin yung mga problems na ito galing sa book nila Sir Gomez, Sir Bravo, and Sir Cruz. So, let us try to solve number one. So, a tank contains 200 gallons of a solution containing 50 pounds of salt dissolved in water. So, meaning to say, meron na tayong nakamix na 50 pounds sa 200 gallons na tubig. So, initially, ang volume natin ay 200 gallons na mayroong laman na 50 pounds. So, yung ating concentration or the amount of salt initially is 50. Ang volume natin ay 20 gallons initially. Tapos, sa sumunod na sentence, pure water is pumped into the tank at the rate 3 gallons per second. So, may ipinasok tayo na pure water. So, syempre, ang concentration niya ay zero kasi wala namang asin kasi pure ito. So, puro. So, walang concentration ng asin dun sa ipinupoured in natin dun sa ating mixture. And a well-mixed brine in the tank flows out at the same rate. So, ang rate of outflow natin is the same as the rate of inflow, which is 3 gallons per second. So, the question is, kailan daw magiging 5 pounds of salt ang matitira into the tank? So, syempre, ang tendency, so, kung may initial tayong volume dito, nagpapasok tayo ng purong tubig, so, of course, tumatabang kasi hindi pa tayo naglalabas, ha? Nagpasok lang tayo ng purong tubig. So, syempre, yung amount ng salt na nandun is still the same, pero tumatabang kasi dinadagdagan natin ng tubig. So, what if sabayan pa natin ng paglabas? So, syempre, habang ito tumatabang, nagbabawas ka rin ng amount ng salt. So, ang tendency, pababa talaga yung amount ng salt salt in that particular tank kasi naglalabas din tayo ng pagbabago ng concentration depende dun sa ipinapasok natin. So ngayon, ang tanong, kailan daw magdadrop up to 5 pounds yung amount ng salt in that particular tank? So let us try to take all the given information. So meron akong tangke. So ang volume ko is 200 gallons na initially meron akong amount ng salt which is 50 pounds. So meron ako ritong 50 pounds of salt initially in that particular tank. So sumunod, naglagay daw tayo, nag-pour in daw tayo ng water, pure water at the rate 3 gallons per second. So pure yun, kaya zero yung concentration. Tapos naglalabas din ako at the same rate 3 gallons per second. So ang concentration of course, since 8 varies, depende dun sa pagpasok at paglabas. So ang ating concentration is the amount divided by yung 200 gallons of water or mixture. So remember, kung naglagay ka ng 3 gallons at maglalabas ka ng 3 gallons din per second, so ang volume natin dito ay constant. Kaya ang ating denominator ay 200 gallons pa din. Kasi naglalagay ka ng 3, naglalabas ka ng 3, hindi nababago yung volume mo, pero ang nababago yung concentration ng salt. So, kailan siya magda-drop into 5 pounds? So, let us try to solve using our formula kanina. So, the rate of the amount of salt is Ra minus Ro, which is B in C in minus B out C out. So, dA dt is equal to B in. Ang B in natin ay 3 gallons. Ang concentration natin ay 0 kasi pure water. Ang ating B out ay 3 gallons per second multiplied by A over 200. So of course, magiging 0 na to. So magiging dA dt is equal to negative 3 over 200 multiplied by A. So pwedeng-pwede na natin itong isolve using variable separable. So that's 200 dA over A by dividing both sides by A and multiplying by dt. So mumultiply natin ito with dt over A. So, syempre, pag dinivide natin sa A, yung nasa right side of the equation, makakancel yung A, matitira negative 3 over 200 dt. Or, you can cross-multiply that 200, kaya napunta rin dito yung 200 para wala tayong denominator. So, mumultiply natin siya with 200 dt over A. So, that's why this 200 cancels out. A also cancels out. So, magiging negative 3 dt na lang yung nasa right side, yung nasa left side becomes 200 dA over A. So, integrating the two, kasi nga it is separated na. So, this is ln of A is equal to negative 3 dt. So, integral ng dt ay t plus of course our constant of integration which is plus c. So, this dividing both sides by 200. So, magiging ln of A is negative 3 over 200 t plus c. So, raising both to e or exponentiating. So, magiging e to the ln A is A. E to the negative 3 over 200 t plus c. But then again, this can be written as e to the negative 3 over 200 t multiplied by e to the c using our algebra. But e to the c is still c, kaya magkakaroon tayo ng a is equal to c, e to the negative 3 over 200 t. So if initially, sabi natin, initially at time t is 0, the amount of salt in that particular tank is 50. So at time t is 0, a is 50 pounds. Substituting, a is 50, c e to the negative 3 over 200 multiplied by at time t is equal to 0. This is 1, then c is equal to 50. So makakakuha tayo ng particular solution, a is equal to 50 e to the negative 3 over 200 of t. So ang tanong, kailan magiging 5 pounds yung aking salt doon sa aking mixture. So, substitute lang natin dito. So, A is 5. We can now solve for the value of T. So, that gives you A, that's 5, equals 50 e to the negative 3 over 200 t. So, the unknown is your t here. So, dividing both sides by 50, magiging 1 over 10 e to the negative 3 over 200 of t. So, again, meron tayong exponent na variable. So, we have to apply natural logarithms on both sides. Magiging ln 1 over 10 is equal to ln e raised to negative 3 over 200 of t. So, this negative 3 over 200 t, pupunta lang siya sa unahan, multiplied by ln e, which is 1. So to solve for the value of t, all I need to do is to multiply this by negative 200, cross multiply, and divide it by 3. So therefore, t here is negative 200 over 3 multiplied by ln 1 over 10, which is equivalent to, using your calculator, you can verify that is 153.51 seconds. So therefore, the answer there is A, 153.51 seconds. So basically, so gagamitin natin yung initial condition para ma-solve natin yung particular solution, and then iano natin, hahanapin natin yung unknown, which is 5 pounds. Kailan siya magiging 5 pounds? So, yun lang ang ginawa natin. Sinolve natin using first order differential equation na method. Then, hinanap ang particular solution and then try to solve for the unknown. So, let us try solving number 2. So, number 2, a tank contains 200 liters of fresh water. So, again, sa tank natin, meron tayong 200 liters ang volume. So, fresh water ito. So, ibig sabihin, walang kahit na anong asin doon kasi it's fresh water. So, sabi dito, brine containing 2 kilograms per liter of salt enters the tank. So, meron na tayong concentration ng asin per liter ang inilalagay natin dun sa ating tank at the rate of 4 liters per minute. And the resulting mixture runs out of the tank at 3 liters per minute. So, ibig sabihin, yung rate ng pagpasok natin ay 4, yung rate ng paglabas natin ay 3. So, ang tendency, mas marami ang ipinapasok kesa inilalabas. So, therefore, pataas ng pataas ang tubig and at the same time, pataas din ng pataas ang concentration ng asin in that particular mixture. So, ang tanong, find the amount of salt in the tank after 30 minutes. So, ibig sabihin, dahil pataas ng pataas, magbabago rin yung concentration ng asin in that particular tank. From 0, dahil fresh water, ilan na kaya after 30 minutes? So, again, ilatag natin ang mga given. So, B in is equal to 4 liters per minute. Yun yung rate of inflow natin. 4 liters per minute. And the result, na merong concentration na 2 kilograms per liter. So, again, ito yung concentration ng salt na ipinapasok natin at the rate 4 liters per minute. So, ang volume natin is expressed in 200 plus T liters kasi meron tayong originally na 200 liters. Meron tayong 4 liters na idinadagdag per minute minus may ibinabawas tayo din na 3 liters per minute so since gumagana siya mumultiply natin siya sa time it takes so ibig sabihin kung t is expressed in minute that cancels out with that gives you 4 minus 3 is 1 times t is t. So, magkakaroon tayo ng volume which is 200 plus T liters. So, ibig sabihin, depende sa number of minutes ang volume mo. Say, for example, after 5 minutes, ilan na ang laman ng tangke? So, that's 205. After 30 minutes, magiging na itong 230. So, kasi nagkakaroon siya ng 1 litro kada minuto. So 1 liter ang nadadagdag sa volume natin kada minuto. So your volume here is 200 plus T liters. Again, ang concentration natin or the amount of salt in that particular tank initially is 0 since fresh water ang laman ng ating tank. So meron tayong rate of outflow na 3 liters per minute. So syempre nagbabawas din, meron tayong A, the amount of salt over 200 plus T pounds per gallon. So again, this is nagbabago at nagbabago rin ang ating volume. So A over 200 plus T gallons ay pounds per gallon. So again, substitute lang natin dun sa ating formula. dA dt is B in C in minus B out C out. So that's dA dt is equal to 4 times 2. Yung 4 mo dito na B in times C in mo na 2. So 4 times 2 minus rate of outflow is 3 multiplied by A over 200 plus T. So this gives you dA is equal to 8 minus 3 over 200 plus dA. So because 4 times 2 is 8. Then 3 over 200 plus T multiplied by A. So if I'm going to transpose this to the left side of the equation, magiging dA dt plus A, 3 over 200 plus T is equal to 8. So which is actually a linear differential equation of dependent A. So diba, sabi natin kapag ka LDE of dependent A, so, i-integrate natin ito para makuha natin yung integrating factor. So, let us try to solve this linear differential equation. So, meron tayong integrating factor. So, i-integrate natin e raised to integral of 3 over 200 plus t. Kaya ang IF natin dito is e raised to integral of 3 over 200 plus t dt. So, this is u 200 plus T, na ang derivative ay dt. So, du over u lang, so magiging 3 ln of 200 plus T. Yung 3, using Lawson logarithm, becomes the exponent. So, magiging e raised to ln 200 plus T raised to the third power. And e raised to ln something is equal to this something. So, that gives you 200 plus T raised to the third power ang ating integrating factor. So, imumultiply natin yung integrating factor natin sa ating mahiwagang LDE, ating integrating factor. So, ang ating integrating factor is done to make our equation on the left side an exact differential. So, derivative of A, the dependent, multiplied by our integrating factor, 200 plus T to the third, is equal to 8 times the quantity 200 plus T to the third power. So, to eliminate this derivative, I need to integrate both sides. So, that's why meron tayong integral of the derivative of A times the quantity 200 plus T cubed is equal to 8 integral of 200 plus T to the third dt. So, pag in-integrate natin, u to the n du. So, that is simply general power formula. At ito naman, integral and derivative cancels out. So, ang mangyayari, magiging na siyang, so, from there, from here, this cancels out, matitira is a 200 plus t to the third. Kaya meron tayo ditong 8 times 200 plus t to the third. Ito naman, using power formula, mag-a-add lang ng 1, magiging to the fourth over 4. So that's why magiging siyang 8 times the quantity 200 plus t to the 4 over 4 plus our constant of integration. So, gives you a 200 plus t to the third equals 2, because 8 divided by 4 is 2, multiplied by 200 plus t to the 4th power plus c. So, this is our general solution. Sabi sa ating problem, meron tayong initial condition that when t is 0, the amount of salt is 0 since fresh water nga ang laman ng ating tanke. Substituting, magiging a is 0 initially times 200 plus 0 because t is 0 to the third is equal to 2 times 200 plus 0 to the fourth plus c. Then the value of c is negative 3.2 times 10 to the 9. So this is 200 to the 4th power multiplied by 2. So that is negative 3.2 times 10 to the 9. Pag na-transpose natin sa left, magiging siyang negative. So that C is negative 3.2 times 10 to the 9. So again, i-plug in mo lang sa calculator, 200 to the 4th multiplied by 2, transpose to the left, magiging negative 3.2 times 10 to the 9. So therefore, our particular solution A times the quantity 200 plus t to the 3rd is equal to 2 times the quantity 200 plus t to the 4th minus 3.2 times 10 to the negative 9 since C is negative 3.2 times 10 to the negative 9. So ang required natin kanina, ilan na raw ang amount ng salt in the tank after 30 minutes. So A, that's the unknown value, times the quantity 200 plus time t is 30 to the 3rd is equal to 2 times 200 plus 30 to the 4th minus 3.2 times 10 to the 9. So that gives you 230 because 200 plus 30 is 230 cubed equals 2 times 230 to the 4th minus 3.2 times 10 to the 9. So, i-plug in lang natin ito sa calcu. Then, the result, i-divide natin kay 230 to the 3rd power. So, therefore, it gives us 196.99 kilogram as our answer. So, ang answer natin dyan is 196.99. So, ibig sabihin, ang answer natin dito ay letter D. So, ibig sabihin, meron na tayong halos 200 kilo ng asin after 30 minutes. Ang dami nun, 200 kilong asin after 30 minutes. So remember, ito lang naman ay for the purpose of solution. So parang ang dami naman ng 200 na kilong asin dun sa ating tank. Okay, number 3, last. A brine tank initially contains 100 grams, gallons. Of salt solution na merong 50 pounds of salt has been dissolved. So again, meron tayong initial na 50 pounds, meron tayong 100 gallons of salt na volume. So a supply pipe fills the tank with brine solution at the rate 3 gallons per minute. Each gallon containing 2 pounds is dissolved. So sabi dito, each gallon containing 2 pounds. So ibig sabihin, ang concentration natin ay 2 pounds per gallon. So that's our rate of or concentration ng salt na ipinapasok natin at the rate 3 gallons per minute. So another pipe empties. So meron namang nagbabawas at the tank at the rate of 2 gallons per minute. Determine the concentration of the salt in the tank after 15 minutes. Yung kaninang tanong, ilan yung amount ng salt? Ngayon, ilan ang concentration ng salt in that particular tank after 15 minutes. So ilatag ulit natin lahat ng given. Ang B in, rate of inflow is 3 gallons per minute. Ang concentration ay 2 pounds per gallon kasi each gallon ito, so 2 pounds per gallon. Ang B out natin ay yung another pipe at the rate of 2 gallons per minute. So syempre, nagbabago ang ating volume dahil magkaiba ang ating inflow sa ating outflow. So that's 3 gal per minute minus 2 gal per minute. So ibig sabihin, kada minuto, nagkakaroon tayo ng isang galon na dagdag sa ating tank. So therefore, our volume changes depende dun sa number of minutes na dumaan. So that's 100 plus 3 minus 2 times T is 100 plus T gallons. So initially, meron ako ritong amount of salt. Initially, this is at time T 0. At time T is equal to 0, the amount of salt in that particular tank is 50 pounds. So determine the concentration of the salt after 15 minutes. So, yon ang hahanapin natin. So, by the way, ang concentration output natin is A, yung nagbabago, over yung volume natin na nagbabago rin, which is 100 plus T pounds per gallon. So, isolve natin siya gamit ulit ang ating na-derive na formula. So, dA dt is B in C in minus B out C out. Ang B in natin ay 3, ang C in natin ay 2. Ang B out natin ay 2, ang concentration output natin ay nagbabago, which is A over 100 plus T. So, dA dt is equal to 6, 3 times 2 is 6, minus 2 over 100 plus T times A. Again, itatranspose natin to sa left side of the equation, magiging dA dt plus A times 2 over 100 plus T is equal to 6. So, ito yung i-integrate natin para makuha natin yung ating integrating factor. So, ang i-integrate natin ay 2 over 100 plus t. So, that's why meron tayo dito na 2 over 100 plus t dt. So, integral ng dt over 100 plus t is du over u. So, ln lamang siya. So, e raised to 2 ln of 100 plus t. This becomes the exponent. So, magiging e raised to ln 100 plus t to the second power. And this gives you simply 100 plus t to the second power. So, if this is our IF, we have to multiply this IF to our original differential equation, giving us this left side of the equation B equal to the exact differential dependent A multiplied by our integrating factor 100 plus t to the second power is equal to 6 times 100 plus t to the second power. So since may derivative, i-integrate lang natin siya both sides. So integral and derivative cancels out, giving you A times the quantity 100 plus t to the second, and this is 6 times the quantity 100 plus t to the second dt using general power formula. So this is u to the n du. So that gives you 2 plus 1 over 2 plus 1. So magkakaroon lang tayo ng 6 times 100 plus t to the third over 3. So which gives us, again, magiging A times 100. So, magka-cancel ang derivative. Pag in-integrate natin ganyan, magka-cancel ang derivative at saka ang integral. So, matitira A times the quantity 100 plus t raised to the second power. Ito yon. At pag in-integrate natin ito with respect to t, gagamit tayo ng general power. Magiging 2 plus 1 is 3. So, that's 3 there. 3 over our denominator 3 plus C. So 6 divided by 3 is 2. So magkakaroon tayo ng general solution na A times the quantity 100 plus T to the second is equal to 2 times the quantity 100 plus T to the third plus C. Again, initially, when T is 0, the initial amount of salt is 50 pounds. So meron tayong 50 pounds initially. So substituting, A is 50 times the quantity 100 plus 0 squared is equal to 2 times 100 cubed is equal to C. So our C here, using our calculator, that's 100 squared times 50. Sa subtract natin yung 100 cubed times 2. That's negative 1.5 times 10 to the 6. So, substituting this C to our general, so magkakaroon tayo ng particular solution na ganito. A times 100 T squared is equal to 2 times 100 plus T cubed minus 1.5 times 10 to the 6. Or, pag mumultiply natin siya by 100 plus T to the negative 2, makakancel out ito, matitira na lang dito sa left side is A equals 2 times 100 plus t to the third times 100 plus t to the negative 2, magiging 1 na lang ang exponent, kaya meron tayo dito to the 1, minus 1.5 times 10 to the 6 times 100 plus t to the negative 2, yung ating multiplier kanina. So ito na yung ating particular solution. But then again, ang required natin ay 15 minutes, kailan daw, ano raw ang kanyang concentration. So, ang concentration natin is defined by A, the amount of salt divided by 100 plus T. So, ang makukuha natin is amount of salt A divided by 100 plus T. Kaya ang ating C, yung na-solve natin na particular solution A, which is 2 times 100 plus T minus 1.5 times 10 to the 6 times 1 plus T, 100 plus T raised to the negative 2. So ito yung ating magiging numerator para makuha natin yung concentration. So meron na tayo nito. That's your A kaninang na-solve, our particular solution, divided by our volume. That's 100 plus T. So substituting, C is equal to 2 minus 1.5 times 10 to the 6 Okay, so ang ginawa dito, dinivide na natin siya by 100 plus T. So, dinivide na siya by 100 plus T. So, magiging C is equal to, dividing this by 100 plus T, magiging 2 minus 1.5 times 10 to the 6. Times 10 to the 6. I-divide itong 100 plus T to the negative 2 by 100 plus T, magiging 100 plus T to the negative 3 na siya. Kasi nag-subtract tayo ng 1 sa negative 2. So, magiging negative 3. So, plugging in, sa substitute lang natin, 100 plus T, ang value ng T ay 15. So, magiging 2 minus 1.5 times 10 to the 6 times the quantity 100 plus 15 to the negative 3. So, that gives you, pag nilagay lang natin siya sa ating calculator, the answer will be 1.01 pounds per gallon. So, ang answer natin ay 1.01 pounds per gallon. So, 1.01 pounds per gallon is letter D. So, that will be our answer.